Billy, you so crazy.
Yo, what's crackin'? What's brackin'? It's your boy, Billy, you so crazy, and we back, and we back, and we back, and we back with another one. Y'all read the title, so already know what I'm doing. This is Puddle of Mud, Blurry. This was suggested, requested by my guy, Jason J. Davis. Shout out to Jason J. Davis. Thank you so much for being a part of the Crazy Pack. It means a lot to me. If you was on to become a Crazy Pack member, just hit the link that's in the description. It's the very first one at the top. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. All my social media links are right there, so feel free to give those a follow and send me a message, all that good stuff, man. I really appreciate all you guys' love and support. But enough talking. We're just going to find out what Puddle of Mud, Blurry is all about. This has to be a really good song because it has over 65 million. At the time of me recording this right now, it might be at 66 by the time you're watching this, but I'm assuming that it has to be a really good song. Okay. I have to pause it for a quick second. Just as long as this song ain't about the little boy that I'm looking at right now, as long as he's not dying, I can make it. I'm good. But I can't deal with any children dying in this song. So please, please. Oh boy. Everything's so blurry, everyone's so fake. I don't like because the filter on the video is giving it a real nostalgia, like memory feel. So I'm really hoping that this is not what I just said that I didn't need this to be about. Oh my gosh, man. Like it has all the antidote, like all the little chemicals or the ingredients that all signs are pointed towards this little boy isn't here. But I'm really hoping that that's not the case. Oh my god. BYSC is about the end of the chat, y'all. Be ready. I wonder what you'll do when imagine where you are. There's oceans in between us, but that's not very far. Can you take it all away? Can you take it all away? When you shove it in my face. Man, that is the worst. Y'all gotta, you know what I'm saying? You gotta be mindful when there's children in the room. If y'all beefing, you know, y'all having like disagreements or debates or whatever, like you gotta be mindful of if your kids is in the room, you know what I'm saying? Like, don't do that stuff around your kids. Like, first of all, they pick up on energy, they pick up on vibes, they pick up on tension, they pick up on all that. So kids are a lot smarter than, you know, we tend to think that they are. And their memories, like, you know, the stuff that they hold on to, like, you ever ask your kid something, you'd be shocked to hear, like, wait, what? You know, like my daughter says things that shock me. Like, how do you remember that? Like, and it's just like you don't really know what is sticking to them. And that's why it's good to just be mindful of, you know what I'm saying? If you having some grown up conversations, don't have it with kids in the room. Don't, especially if you and your significant other is beefing, the best thing for you to do is to go ahead and bottle it up and save it for later, or try to talk about it in regular voices. So that way that they're not thinking that, oh, this is the way that things are supposed to be. We should be yelling at each other, which, you know, is really hard to effectively communicate when you're yelling, for one, you know. And I will be the first to admit that it took me a long time because I came up in a household where yelling was the way of talking. It took me a long time to learn that I can't just be yelling. And I'm someone that gets, like, when I'm passionate, my voice volume goes a lot louder. So I had to learn how to, you know, adjust that from like me just yelling to, you know, like knowing that, okay, I'm feeling passionate about this situation. So let me be mindful of my voice. Let me be mindful of the energy that I am sending out and be in control of my own emotions. Because sometimes you let them emotions let loose and all hell breaks loose, like literally. So I didn't mean to turn this into a TED talk. My apologies. But BYSC has entered the chat. Like, what do you expect? Billy, you so emotional, has entered the chat. So, like, this is what you get. This is what y'all wanted. This is what you're going to get. Oh, my gosh, man. Just don't let the little boy die. Please. I can't. Okay. All right. I do like him spending time with his dad and stuff, but, you know, growing up in an unhealthy household, that ain't good. Okay, I see it's a co-parenting thing. You know, they broke up and now she has a new boyfriend and he looks like he just... So that was the new boyfriend of them arguing and the little boy watching. That's what happened, right? You guys are going to murder me in the comment section. I'm sorry. I got way too in my feelings to even realize that that might have been two different people. Oh my gosh. Y'all going to kill me in the comment section. Oh, shoot. Okay, now I have to rewind it from the beginning just to see. I didn't even peep. I didn't even peep that at the beginning. It was... Wow. Wow. Oh, okay, 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 okay. So I gave y'all that whole speech. And this is one of those co-parenting situations. And a little boy had to watch his mom just getting yelled at by some stranger, because that's not his dad. Okay. All right. And he's finally at peace when he's with his dad. Wow. This was heavy. I was so caught up on the fact of the little boy possibly dying that I wasn't even paying attention to the video. My apologies, y'all. My bad, Jason. Like, but this was deep. Whoa. Well, this brings up another topic. You know, if you are single, I don't want to say like single parent, but if you are in a situation where you're co-parenting and stuff, you know, you guys both got to be mindful of the people that you do bring around your kids and the conversations that you're having with your significant other, with your kids in a room and stuff. Like, it, you know, what I said earlier still holds weight up until right now. Like, you know, you shouldn't be having these debates, or your kids shouldn't have to see you arguing with, you know, the person that you're with that may not be their parent or whatever. Like, you know, you got to think about the stuff that you're teaching your kids, you know, you kind of letting them know that that's okay. But you also want to make them feel safe in their own home. Like that little boy, clearly he felt uncomfortable with his mom. He looked like he couldn't wait to finally go see his dad and spend that time with his dad. You know, it looked like he didn't even get a chance to really spend time with his mom because, you know, her new boyfriend, her husband, I don't really know who, they didn't show, I didn't see a ring. It's not like I was really looking, but man, this is a conversation starter. This video right here is heavy. You know, it's gonna be somebody in the comment section that already, they didn't stick around to the end to find out that I did eventually figure it out. But I understand if I'm gonna see some hate comments. My apologies, but that was heavy, man. Y'all know what happens when Billy, you so emotional, comes in. I done knocked out my headphone piece. Like, this is crazy. So look, man, if you guys did enjoy the reaction, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. I understand. You know what I'm saying? I dropped the ball on the whole point of it at the start of it. It was a good song, though. I did. Shout out to Puddle of Mud. I was about to call them something else. Blurry. Shout out to Jason for requesting it. Follow me on all my social media links, all that good stuff, man. I'm going to end it on that note. It is your boy, Billy You So Crazy. And I'll see you on the next video, man. I'm out this thing.